and then your traffic police catch you and ask you what is your vehicle number, how many of you struggle to remember your vehicle number? What is? Suppose you have parked your vehicle, the same brand, but you forgot your number. Then you have to wait for everyone to take away their vehicle to find out yours. And where is that information in my brain? It may be in one of the neurons. So simple, no? So our brain is just like a cricket ball size. All the information are there. Why we are not able to find out? Because we are not having just one neuron. According to psychologists, we have got millions and millions of neurons. So like stars of galaxy, no? And we cannot find out which information is located in which neuron. Once you know that, we can go there and pick it up. But it's not so easy to pick up the exact neuron where that information is stored in the brain. So we need an organization. We need to organize the information in our brain, like in a big organization, how they store the information so that they can reveal it out, they can take it out whenever they want. Okay, I like to do a live demonstration. And you are going to give me something now, what I am going to ask you. And that will be written on the board. And I am going to recite it back again. And you can ask me questions randomly. It's going to be live. See, this is not which I have memorized already yesterday or so many years. What you are going to give right now. So there are six rows. See, I like to take mixed things, not the same concept. The first two rows, audience can give any double digit number from 00 to 99. Any double digit number. And she'll be writing it on the screen, on the board in fact. And third row and fourth row, you can give any card from the 52 packs. There is a backup card contains 52 cards. Randomly you can give some 20 cards which will be written on the board in the third row and fourth row. And fifth row and sixth row, you can give any binary digits in any random order. So each box will have three binary digits. So you can, audience can give it now. Whatever comes to your mind, right now you can give them. Okay, first let us take the first two rows. You can give any double digit number. Now you can give any backup card. I like to listen once if anybody could read out the numbers for me or whatever is there in the board. So when I say yes, you can go to the next number, please.
That's 29.
Okay.
24.
Okay.
25.
Okay.
73.
Okay.
54.
Okay.
68.
Okay. Okay.
Club 9.
Okay.
Art 7.
Okay.
Art 6.
Okay.
Diamond 2.
Dice 2. Okay.
Diamond 2. And
okay, let me recall. If it is correct, you say yes. 29.
Yes.
24.
Yes.
25.
Yes.
73.
Yes.
54.
Yes.
68. 1.
Yes.
17.
Yes.
37.
Yes.
44.
Yes.
Okay, then hearts yes.
Yes.
Straight king. Club 9,
yes.
Heart 7,
yes.
And then Dice King,
yes.
Heart 7,
yes.
Club 9,
yes.
Again Heart 7,
yes.
Again Dice King,
yes.
And then Club Jack,
yes.
Club Queen,
yes.
And then Dice 2,
yes.
And then Club King.
Yes.
So these are the cards. And coming to binary digits, 010, 101, 111, 010, and then 100, 101. Then 011, 101, 110, 111, and then it is 001, 100. It can be traced. So what I did was, us, I have created a mental file. I ask you, can we create a mental file and store the information in an order so that we can pull it out whenever we want? And so this is what the idea I'd like to share with you today. And I'm going to explain you how I did it, so which may be useful in your students' life. And once you leave college, it will be very useful when you enter into any workforce also. So let us see one by one. So this is what is called Clavey method, first of all. Just think visually. That's the key. This is what our ancient people followed. They converted everything into picture. So P stands for picture. Whatever the illusion, first you convert into a picture. And when you see it as a picture, you need a location. Suppose I'm telling you, your mom is cooking. Can you visualize your mom cooking in the sky? In the kitchen, am I right? But I never mentioned the kitchen. That location comes automatically. So when you think of something in the form of picture, you need a location. That comes automatically. Then associate. Suppose you want to learn something new, you have to connect them together. You have to associate them in a meaningful way. Sometimes maybe meaningless way. Yes, sir. That's all. Then last one, Y stands for the last letter, funny. That should be humorous. We all love fun. Otherwise, we will not be here. We want to have fun. That's why we are here. And how to make that association fun-filled? Okay, just I will explain you later. The last one, V stands for visualization. That's the key. Think visually. Suppose the trick is how to convert those abstract information into concrete images. That's the key. Okay, I'm going to take you some hard vocabulary, maybe having it in your GRE when you are preparing for your higher studies. I'd like to take some 10 words from it and how this technique can be applied. Okay, now, suppose I give you capsule, remember it? And second one, gold coin. Yes, you can remember it. But don't take the words as it is. See them as a picture. Capsule, immediately you have to see it as a picture. And gold coins, immediately you convert that into a picture. Now, how you can make the association between these two? That association may be meaningless. See, for example here, what I have done. The capsule is stuffed with gold coin. Right? It makes you to laugh, that's all. The moment you get some humorous in it, we have seen it, you have enjoyed it, that will stick very well in your brain, that's all. Okay, after doing this, visualize it. Suppose a capsule filled with gold coin. Just see that in your mind's eye. Visualize it. Maybe Dr. Whitman is giving all of us a capsule today filled with gold coins. We all will be really happy. Okay, just visualize that. Okay, next. Add details to it. Once you have visualized, add details to it. See, you have seen it first of all. Use all your sensory channels. All five senses we have to use it. How it looks like, you have to see it in your mindset. Second one. Suppose you shake the capsule, you can hear the sound exactly. And third, you can smell it, how it smells. And then even you can taste it. Okay, it may not be the sweetest taste in the world, but still you can taste it. And the last one, you can touch it and feel it exactly. Use as many senses as possible. But honestly speaking, 95% of brain remembers what you see visually. All other senses help you only 1%. Reading louder. Okay, parents may be very happy. The child is studying. But there's no guarantee they are learning. But we have to visualize what we are in fact reading or what we are trying to learn. Okay, next one. I give you, see, there are many things which cannot be seen as a picture. Capsule, gold coin can be seen as a picture. The children will be studying something like this. What's the capital of Norway? Oslo. The capital of Norway is Oslo. They'll be repeating 5 times. Repeat, repeat, repeat. Then next day, they'll write in the test, they score 10 out of 10. After 1 week, same question is asked, there's no guarantee the child will be able to recall. Okay, so same, see how we can remember this. Similarly, Sweden, Stockholm, how we can apply this technique? See, first word is picture, no? First we have to convert them into a picture. How can you see Norway as a picture? Okay, Norway is a country, we can see it as a picture. But the word should come to your mind. How you can remember this? We can apply Rasa system. That is a rhyming word. Find a rhyming word. Norway, there is no way to Norway. And Oslo, please go slow to Oslo. Now it becomes rhyming. It becomes easy to remember. Celebration. It's rhyming with what? You can immediately find out. Celebration. This word is rhyming with what word? Celebration. That's it. So you can visualize a celebration. And then cerebellum. Okay. Anything. Cerebellum is related with brain. Then what is a celebration? Celebration is going on in the cerebellum. Okay. And Vishwanathan Anand is using his deep thought, no? Using his brain. And next one, the chess game always requires much celebration. Next one, castigate. Next one is castigate. So criticize severely. Castigate, how can you see it as a picture? Castigate. A gate made of cast iron. So just you can visualize this. A picture came to my mind immediately. And scold severely. This is what. And what's the example you can give? Rita's mom castigated her accidentally breaking her toys. So castigate, cast iron gate. And someone is scolding in front of the gate. So you will get the meaning as well. Okay, next one. Pungent. Well, we know that. It's an irritating smell. And it is sharp and irritating to the senses. See, pungent, immediately the word came to my mind was pungent. A gent is eating a bun. So this is a picture. And this is smelling very bad. And the head cook is testing it. Okay, see, you have to visualize everything. When you are reading something, it should trigger something in your mind in the form of images. If the trigger is not there, if the images is not created, you can be very sure you will forget. You cannot remember. Okay. And the bad smell from the spoiled food was pungent. Next one, Malinger. So immediately the picture come to my mind was a cricketer from Sri Lanka. Who is it? Malinger. Okay, immediately you can get Malinger hair, Malinger. Okay, what's the meaning? To evade responsibility by pretending to be ill. So whenever he is a Malinger hat, that makes him Malinger. And he is pretending to be ill on the important thing. Okay, that's it. Just that should create some image. See, Malingering, Malinga always seem to be fall ill on the dates of important matches. Okay. Next one, boisterous. It's violent. Very rough. Okay. Boys terrace. Boys are in the terrace. Or boys terrace. Anything. So nothing is wrong. If you are not imagining, if you are not creating any imagery, you are wrong. It need not be meaningful. As long as it creates images, that's fine. Okay, then what's the meaning of that? It's violent thing. The boys are on the street. Some violence is going on. So you can visualize, you can imagine it as a picture. And it turned very violent and police opened fire. Okay, so you can see the unruly crowd became more boisterous when police tried to fight them. Okay. Irascible. Easily made angry. Immediately who comes to our mind? College professor, right? But irascible. Okay, you can easily get irascible. The picture comes to my mind was erasable. Erasable. Okay, you can see. A picture of eraser, and you are erasing something, you are erasing it. And you can see your professor getting angry for everything. Okay. My professor is very erasable, it's erasable. Okay, you can use it in some sentences. Okay, now, where it is there in your brain? You have learned some 10 words. If I ask you, you will be able to answer me correctly. Okay, what's the meaning of stolid? Unemotional. Okay, you can see the picture is coming back to your mind, am I right? Okay, now, can you tell me where it is stored in your brain? Where it is stored in your brain? Can you tell me? No, it is somewhere there. Of the millions of neurons, it is somewhere there. So that's what I like to quickly go through, that how you can store it in your brain. Okay, let us take this call. Let us create a mental file of this one. See, here, this is the hall where we are right now in. Okay, now we want to remember some 10 words. Create a mental file using the same one, because I cannot give something which all of us know commonly other than this one. Because now we are in this hall, we can see, understand everything. Okay, now I have numbered this hall, so the entrance, no, that's the door there. And that's the entrance, that's the first place. The second one is a screen right now. And the third one, okay, the projector here. And the fourth one, the stage here. And the fifth place is a window over there. And the sixth one, okay, the first row, this side, the benches there. And the sixth one, there is a pathway in the middle. Okay, during the break, you can check it out and you can keep it in your brain. The pathway is here. And next one, the speaker at the back side. And the next one, the back side wall. The back side of the for the wall. And the last one, the ceiling. The ceiling on top. So these are the 10 places. Now, you can very easily store everything. So this is the first place. So what is the first one? Can you recall the word? Problem. Okay, just imagine an ant is pulling a car driven by a batman. Can you visualize something is happening in that place? You can see it in your mind's eye. Okay, what's the second one? The screen. What was happening in the screen? Now, what is this picture? Yes. So you are getting, once I am giving you the picture, you are getting the word. Am I right? What is the word? Bombastic. Okay. So someone is speaking on the screen. Bombastic. Okay. You can imagine me. I am giving a bombastic speech here. Okay. And third one is a projector there. And by looking at the picture, you should be able to celebrate. Okay. So you will be able to get exactly the picture. What is the fourth place? The stage. The stage here. Okay. Can you tell me what's the word? A line made of ice is here, standing here, and you are speaking everybody as a celebrity. Okay, just imagine that. That's it. Okay, what is the next place? The window over there. It's a window over there. And what's the next one? By looking at the picture, you should be able to tell me. Castigate. What's the meaning? Okay, so you can get it. What's the next place? The benches over there. Okay, what is it? Pungent, pungent. Okay, somebody is sitting there and eating a spoiled bun there. And just giving a pungent smell. It's irritating. Okay, it's all happening there in the desk. You can visualize that as if it's happening there. Okay, what's the next one? The pathway. And you can easily get it. So what's the word? Nalinger. So you can immediately visualize. He's hiding there, pretending as to be ill. Okay, what's the next one? The speaker. Voiceless. Okay, what's the meaning? Violent. Okay, it's happening in the speaker over there. You can just visualize that. See, anybody enters into the hall for the lecture next time, you should get all the pictures. Then you come back automatically. Okay, what's the next one? The last back wall. Okay, so you can get it exactly what this picture speaks and what word you should derive from this picture. I need not explain. Okay, what's the next one? The ceiling. Okay, you are raising something sitting on the ceiling. What is it? Elizabeth. Okay, you are the professor is shouting there on top of the ceiling. Okay, just visualize that. Hope you have understood this. Can you recall this now? What is the first place? What do you think? Popular. The second one? Bombastic. The third one? Celebrate. Blind eyes. The fifth one? The door? Castigate. Sixth one? Sanjay, seventh one? Nalinga, eighth one? Okay, then seventh one here? Nalinga. Eighth one? Watch this. Nine? Solid. Tenth one? So, this is the idea I wanted to spread with you and share with you. Memory is an art, memory is a skill. It can be scientifically trained. Okay, thank you very much for your attention.